Hey guys, this is Martin again from SIRS Electronics, and today I wanted to talk to you about Madrix and the different options that the Madrix family offers. And, you know, there's a lot of different options. There's like the Madrix Neo, the Plexus, the Basic Key, the Pro Key, Ultimate Key. And, you know, it gets confusing because there's all these different options, and you may be wondering, okay, well, which one should I buy? You know, since there's so many options, what are the differences between them? Well, today I'm going to answer some of those questions for you. The most basic option that Madrix offers is the Madrix Neo. The Madrix Neo comes with a DMX to USB interface, such as this one right here, and it's the most easiest version of Madrix. This is a plug-and-play interface. All you do is you load the program on the computer, you plug in the interface, and there you go. This one, it includes 512 DMX channels, which is a one DMX universe, and that's a good amount of channels, but if you're going to be doing something that's relatively large scale, this is not going to cut it. So then there's the Madrix Plexus, which is this one right here. This one comes with two DMX universes, which is 1,024 channels, and that's a little bit more channels to play around with. But the cool thing about the Madrix Plexus is it's a standalone ability. This little device here, you can load the program and all the presets that you programmed on the software, you load them onto here, and you could play the show just from here without the computer. You plug in your power supply, and you're ready to go. And you know, you have your DMX outputs here, one and two for each universe, and it's a little cool interface, but you know, it's 1,024 channels. It's a good amount, but if you still need more, then there's the Madrix Basic Key. The Basic Key, it just comes with the software and its little USB key that unlocks the software so that you could run the software. The Madrix Basic Key comes with 16 DMX universes. That's a lot more than two. But the downside to this is that it does not come with an interface. So you need to incorporate your own interface. Madrix is pretty good at being compatible with a bunch of different manufacturers. You know, you could use the Madrix Luna, which is an 8-node DMX interface. You can use Yantic DataGate MK2, and you can use our DMX Net 8. Those are 8-node interfaces. So you know, the more universes you need, the more interfaces you're gonna need. But if it's still 16 DMX universes are not enough, because you're some mad scientist and you want to create some crazy large project, then you can go with a Pro. The Madrix Pro Key, it has 64 DMX universes. 64 universes is a lot. You know, with this you could create screens, you could create really, really cool pixel effects and things that are going to require a lot of channels. But if that's still not enough, because you just can't get enough of Madrix, then you need the Ultimate Key. You know, the Ultimate Key has 256 DMX universes. That's a lot, okay? And with 256 DMX universes, you could pretty much make anything happen with that, you know? The cool thing about Madrix is that the software is the same, whether you go from the Neo to the Ultimate. The software structure and everything's the same. The only thing that changes is how many DMX universes you have available to play around with. So with the Ultimate, it's the same story. You know, you need to incorporate your own interface and all that, depending how many universes you're going to be using, you could choose your interface. The cool thing about Madrix is that it's very good at being compatible with a lot of different interfaces. You know, it could go anywhere from like the Sunlight Easy standalone to like the Antec to like the EQ. You know, so you know, there's a bunch of different interfaces that are compatible with Madrix, and that's a very cool thing. The other cool thing about Madrix is that it has a self-mapping ability. So instead of programming channel by channel, color by color, pixel by pixel, and trying to create chases and effects and words and all this cool stuff that you could do with Madrix, instead of doing that one by one with other similar softwares, here you just, you know, pretty much input your x-axis by your y-axis of pixels, and there you go, it's mapped out for you. And it comes with a bunch of cool presets that you could change the speed, the colors, the frequency, and all that cool stuff. So you don't have to actually sit there and program effects. This is really cool. It comes with a bunch of presets, you know, and doesn't get any much easier than that. The cool thing about Madrix is that if you're into programming, you could actually program your own effects aside from the ones that Madrix already comes with. So that's another cool feature. So, you know, Madrix is a great product. It's also compatible with other protocols other than DMX. You can use it with DVI, you can use it with ArtNet, you can use it with Color9 Color Smart Link. You can use it with a streaming ACN, and a bunch of different protocols. So, you know, Madrix is a great product, great software, great hardware, really easy to set up. It'll save you a lot of time, and it's a very good product. So if you guys have any other questions and comments or concerns or anything like that, you could drop us a comment there in the comment box. So I hope this video has really helped you guys out, and thanks for watching.